Thank you. Greetings. It gives me great pleasure to share my work with you through this presentation. My name is Hyonok Kim. I'm a dancer, choreographer, director, and filmmaker. I've been making dance films since 1984. This began in Paris, where I studied dance and became engaged in the collaboration between dance and video, which was a strong, exciting movement at the time. From Paris, I moved to New York, where I made film Night Divide Yourself in collaboration with director Zhang de Boisson, for which we received the Dance on Camera Gold Award in 1992. I moved back to home country, Korea, to become a professor of dance at Kaemyung University. Throughout these years, I have steadily created dance films informed by my own personal fusion of Korean and Western culture. I now live and work in New York. In my film, I want to create an effect similar to the silent film that have deeply influenced my work. Their concentration on gestures, body language, close-up, facial expression carry intense emotional meaning. Instead of using dialogue, I want to create a new language using music, the human body movement, and sometimes poetry. Because I believe that nature has spirit, I want to capture the spiritual power in dance film and bring it back to the theater. My personal challenge is to put dancer in a specific environment of nature, creating dance in a usual setting. I would say that there are stages to create a dance film: inspiration, inner necessity, research, rehearsal, emphasizing between the camera and the dance, storyboard, shooting, editing. I will present you 8 of my film and describe how I worked on them. I'd like to start with my first film, Night Divide Yourself. In this film, I was inspired by the composer Lee Sang-yoon's music piece, Stylish Knot. It uses German poem by Nobel Prize poet Nelly Jacques. Lee Sang-yoon is 20th century the most important composer, together with Stravinsky. When I listened to the music, I was overwhelmed by the musical message. I felt sometimes very dark, but ray of light. I had a strong urge to express in dance what I received from the music. I felt like a kind of inner necessity. He told me that his music is based on Korean traditional three-word philosophy, representing cosmic structure, heaven, earth, and between them the human. I tried to apply the three-realm philosophy by spatial design using a chair divided into three levels. The main concept is to escape from entrapment. To express this, the space is divided between the enclosed studio and bus seat. Relationship between dance and music in this film, I explored that idea through the relationship between dance and music using a Korean shamanistic tradition, geulche and milche, meaning pull and push. Music pulls dance, sometimes dance pushes music. Here I apply the theory of milche, dance comes first, and push music to come.
Du siehst, was dahinter geschah.
Camera angle is a philosophy. Depending which angle you place the camera, it can create different meanings. Dancing with the camera for each scene, coordinating the camera's movement and dance movement, which means placing emphasizes on camera angle and camera movement in connection with the dance. In the sense, the camera has to become a dancer and become part of the choreography. The chair and sea are used as metaphors of civilization and nature. I use symbolic and metaphoric objects as projection of human body or spirit in dance film. I choreograph in a cinematic way using chair as a metaphoric door and hitting hair as a plea to open the door.
Ich will.
Came from Renaissance painting by Giovanni Bellini, The Death of Cleopatra by a Viper. We freeze the frame and four figures appear one after another. I was inspired by the image of a Korean urn. I want to take this daily life vessel and use it differently in a dance film. The Korean urn represents Korean culture. As an object close to daily life, it is used to preserve basic food such as kimchi and bean paste. It is also a symbol of slow time, the long time spent waiting for life to be ready. This is why my title reference Keats' poem Ode on a Grecian Urn, which is about the vessel survived intact over a long period of time. It is representing of awakening soul. The film was shot mainly in traditional Confucius architecture, Hanakjeon at Kyemyang University in film release in Korea and at the Royal Palace in Paris. At Chateau de Rochechouart in France, I wanted to convey interconnection and communication between cultures which have a deep personal meaning for me. Ode on a Korean Aunt conveys longing for hope and healing. In the film, Korean Aunt is used as a metaphoric object visually and audibly in a poetic way. In ancient time, people communicated through drumming. In dance, the urn became the instrument, the percussion, and symbol of global communication. It represents an awakening soul. Reflected in the camera work, particularly the anger. During the section asking the question, will spring ever come, camera work is horizontal, then the camera work becomes vertical as if the question comes from the earth. Camera tilting. In this film, with the camera tilting, the space is transferred and even crossed the continent. The percussion is done in Korea in one location and continue in France in medieval city. Many imagery of dancing on the plum blossom and playing with it revealed my childhood memory. It is fascinating to realize that the unconsciousness is revealed in the film. Isla Waiting Soul, the film was inspired by the essence of shamanism in which the realm of human, animal, and vegetation are unified as one. Souls are believed to be wanderers waiting to go another realm after death, conveys wandering soul, their journey and adventure. Location in this film is very important element. I had an idea of desert to convey the solitude, surreal, secluded atmosphere. Because the atmosphere is what drives expressiveness of dancer in the film. Director Bong Joon-ho of Parasite emphasizes how critical is location. He said, space does not stop with a simple background. Location and architecture play an important supporting role, revealing a clear character, forming an atmosphere for the story and suggesting a turning point. Passion centers around the theme of death with the music of Bach, the Passion of St. Matthew. Stretching the neck and casting eyes towards sky is the meaning of death in Renaissance painting, which implicated in the choreography. Interestingly, Alfred Hitchcock used the same symbolism in Psycho. I researched the theme of death in Renaissance and Baroque painting, as well imagery stabat mater. It depicts a woman in sorrow and a man who consoles her with his intense attention. The inspiration came from the death of my younger sister and wishing to bring her healing. Flight of the Soul. This film conveys a journey of the soul after death. I wanted to convey the spiritual ascension, the flight. It is mystical and impossible to balance these two opposites, the mystical experience and the technological idea of flight. Thank you. Red Horse is inspired by Tang Dynasty poetry. The film explores the mythical, spiritual, and intimate relationship between human and horses in order to examine and restore our lost contact with nature. I choose two Tang poems, Selling My Horse by Baekgeui and Seahorse by Du Fu. I made a plot out of it and storyboarded the action.
麦洛马，白居易。五年花下醉骑行，临迈回头思一生。向极故追犹解叹，乐天别落岂无情。
I was interested in how horses perceive their environments and respond to human beings. After the experience of meeting horses at close range, I became aware of how they express themselves by gestures, especially by their neck, ear, tail, and eyes. I started to think about echoing movement the way I think about dancers using their neck, hands, and eyes. Decided to create a dance in which horse movements were performed by dancers.
is inspired by watching the sunrise of the sea for many years, wanting to share the sensation of magical moment with an audience. I had an appointment with a boatman at 4 o'clock at the dawn, who brought us in the open water. We shot entire film only at sunrise. We shot from a boat led by a boatman. Actually, the boatman's movement became camera movement. Another challenge was to coordinate the dancer's movement and boat movement. Sometimes it was smooth, but sometimes the current took away both dancer and boat to an unexpected direction. It was a challenge for the dancer to stand still and dance on top of a surfboard, which is extremely difficult. It was part of a dramaturgy. Weeping Water. For this film, I was inspired by watching Rob Stewart documentary Shark Water Extinction. It is based on the tragic reality that people were killing sharks in order to make shark fin soup. I witnessed these sea animals massacred because of human cruelty, greed, and ignorance. When Stewart film revealed that the fin was sold for 50 cents, I felt such empathy for the sharks that I was driven to make Weeping Water. Between shark protagonist and human predator, the dancer fought against the camera as if it was hunter. Thank you. as I was editing, coronavirus pandemic peaked. Then I realized that what happened to the shark life on the water can be totally related to human suffering, this predatory disease. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching the presentation. I think that when you create a work, it is important to have a strong inspiration, an inner necessity. Kandinsky emphasized inner necessity in art. He said, when you create a work of art from inner necessity, you don't need to show to critics. Most of my films are short, but for me, making a 10-minute take 1 year because I have an elaborate process. In spite of storyboarding, what happens when we film becomes completely spontaneous. It is important to leave free space for that to happen. I think that it is also important for dance film to be accessible to larger audience. I hope it was helpful for you. Thank you very much for watching it.